Hi there. Did you know that drinking alcohol regularly can put you at a greater risk of experiencing health problems, including dementia? Stay tuned to learn more. This video is part of a series on how to identify and reduce risk factors for dementia. Dementia is a general term for loss of memory, language, problem solving, and other thinking abilities that are severe enough to interfere with daily life. Alzheimer's disease and vascular dementia are two of the most common types of dementia. You may have heard that drinking large amounts of alcohol can lead to health problems, such as high blood pressure, liver disease, stroke, and heart disease. But did you know that heavy drinking can also increase the risk of dementia later on in life? The purpose of this video is to clarify the effect that alcohol can have on your health and give you tips about how you may reduce your alcohol consumption. First, it is important to understand what a standard serving size for different alcoholic drinks is. This can help you keep track of how much alcohol you are consuming. Generally, the higher the alcohol percentage of a drink, the smaller the serving size should be. Alcohol percentages are often displayed on the bottle or provided on restaurants' menus. The alcohol content in liquor, such as gin or vodka, is about 40%, and a standard serving is 1.5 ounces, or the size of a typical shot glass. The alcohol content in wine is about 12%, and a standard serving is approximately 5 ounces. Lastly, beer has an alcohol percentage of about 5%, and a standard serving is about 12 ounces. These percentages are based on what is average, and some types of liquor, beer, and wine may contain more or less alcohol than listed above. Because of this, it is important to check the listed alcohol content and adjust your consumption amount accordingly. How much alcohol is considered too much? Well, when defining heavy or problematic drinking, there are differences between men and women. For men, heavy drinking is having 15 or more servings of alcohol in a week. That is equal to about 15 regular cans of beer or 15 5-ounce glasses of wine per week. For men, a good rule of thumb is to stay within or below an average of 2 drinks per day. Additionally, it is better to space out drinking than to get your weekly allowance of alcohol through binge drinking. Binge drinking, which for men is defined as having more than 5 drinks on the same occasion, can be very harmful to your health. For women, heavy or problematic drinking is defined as having 8 or more standard drinks in a week. Therefore, it's recommended to have no more than 1 drink per day. It may seem surprising that women should only drink about half the amount of alcohol recommended for men. But in addition to having, on average, smaller body frames, women have less of the key liver enzyme that helps break alcohol down. Binge drinking for women is defined as consuming more than 4 drinks on one occasion. But how much do you have to drink to increase your risk of getting dementia? Research results indicate that regular drinking, even at rates below the recommended threshold of heavy drinking, can increase dementia risk. Adults between the ages of 45 and 65 who drink about 12 standard drinks per week have a 20% higher risk of developing dementia than those who drink less. Heavy drinking can put people at a greater risk of a variety of other health problems, such as high blood pressure and stroke. And these health problems can also contribute to an increased risk of dementia. So if you are a heavy drinker, cutting back on alcohol can reduce your chances of developing dementia and can help prevent other health problems that may contribute to dementia. Heavy alcohol drinking can also cause other adverse health effects on your sleep, mood, energy levels, and weight. When drinking alcohol, you are more likely to fall or have other accidents which can cause various injuries, including traumatic brain injuries. Falling when under the influence of alcohol can be particularly dangerous for older adults. For some people, heavy drinking can increase the risk of developing an alcohol use disorder, where people are no longer able to control their alcohol intake. Now that we know the risks associated with heavy drinking, what can we do to reduce our alcohol intake? First, try to set reasonable goals on how long you go without drinking alcohol. This can be anywhere from months, weeks, or even just every other day. Instead, try consuming non-alcoholic drinks that you might enjoy or are similar in consistency or taste, such as sparkling water or fruit juices such as cranberry or grape juice. Starting off with small changes can help make it easier to reduce or completely remove alcohol from your diet. If you plan on continuing to drink alcohol, decide ahead of time how much you plan on drinking and stick to that plan. If you are attending a social gathering, you can bring a set amount of drinks so that you know exactly how much you have consumed that day. Remember when we discussed the standard size of alcoholic beverages? Make sure that the drinks you consume are not larger than the standard serving size. It can also be better to consume less than the standard serving. You can enjoy drinking in smaller portions or pick drink options that have lower alcohol content. For example, some brands have light options that have lower alcohol content. If you're in an environment where you'll be drinking alcohol, consider taking a break from alcoholic drinks by staying hydrated with water. You can also volunteer to be the designated driver for social events so you will not be tempted to drink alcohol. Peer pressure can also make people drink more than they should. Remember, it's okay to refuse a drink if it's offered to you. There's nothing to be afraid or ashamed of. In general, it is not wise to surround yourself with other heavy drinkers, as this can influence you to drink more than you should. Also, don't be afraid to share your intentions on decreasing your alcohol intake with your social circle. Your friends want the best for you, and informing them of your lifestyle changes can help them to encourage you to reach your goals. If you are struggling to reduce your alcohol intake or feel that you're suffering from alcohol overconsumption, don't be afraid to reach out to your family doctor or other health professionals for additional support.